Lara, it was Feb 14, 2018, when I first had the thought that I wanted to marry you. You know this date already, but not the full story. And I clearly remember the date and did my best not to tell you for two reasons. One, I knew that someday I had to keep this story at my back pocket, just in case I struggled to open my vows. And guess what? I struggled.
I've waited 100 years, but I'd wait 1,000,000 more for you.
The second reason is it was Valentine's Day. It was a day that we said we didn't like celebrating. And yet that day I kind of felt that I wanted to do something special for you. So I woke up at 3 a.m. in the morning, I went to Dangwa, and I picked some flowers for you and surprised you, gave you the flowers in the morning. You were of course surprised, because we both said before, ayaw natin ang flowers, they're very impractical. While you were sitting beside a window, there were curtains, very thin, and the sun wasn't too bright, just like today, but it was still enough to make you glow while holding the bouquet that I gave. You were beautiful that day. That moment gave me a vision where my life could possibly lead with you. And now I'm still in awe that that vision's coming to reality.
My love, allow me to start by saying thank you. You have been a positive influence in my life, even when we were just friends. I think all this time, I've been too proud to admit that you made my life better. We tread this life and we experience things that break us. And life has broken me many times, more than one should deserve. And I think because of that, I was late to understand what self-love is. It took a while and a lot of effort to find my sense of self. And lo and behold, you came along just when I gathered my bearings. Even when I told myself that I knew what love is, it was you who showed me what it truly means. Ganito pala ang pakiramdam ng mahalin ng tunay.
May I request everyone to please stand up as we welcome back the newlyweds, John and Lara!
Video yan, tita. Video.
Ay, ah! Ah, okay!
Hanggang
sa ako.
Ganda mo naman, pampalimpit.
Sinasuido!
Gracia!
Security,
sa telepon.
Email kami, through email kami.
Oh my God!
So my immediate response was to push you away. And I didn't want to risk losing myself again. I was understandably and terribly afraid of being broken again. But my love, as I've said before, you took me back to a time of innocence when I didn't know pain, I didn't know betrayal, and I didn't know abandonment.
When I do struggle to solve a problem, you give me the space to think, because you know that sometimes, or maybe a little more often, I can be too stubborn to take suggestions, especially when I'm stressed.
Yes.
I promise to continue watching your form when you lift weights and you do squats. When you work out with me, I'll watch you. I will continue being your personal chef. I promise not to try too much black pepper on your food, except for the maybe long list of dishes that I have where I'd say it belongs there. I promise to continue sending you photos of cats until I persuade you to get a third one, maybe a fourth one or a fifth one. Lastly, I vow to have our relationship to be the core of every decision I make with you side by side. I look forward to spending every day with you as my wife from today and for as long as our lives allow us to. I love you.
Until now, I still don't believe in the whole institution of marriage or the sentimental idea of forever. But because of you, I started believing in possibilities. And the possibility of us loving each other for the rest of our finite lives is now what I firmly believe in and is the reason why I'm standing here before you. I love you, John.
Mr. John Jimenez, you may now kiss your wife.